And we're live. Yes, we're live. Hey guys, thanks for joining me. My name is Jessica, the Furry Family Coach. And in today's video, I pulled out my cute little blanket, my doggy blanket. So cute. Okay. So I've got my little doggy blanket back here. So soft. It's like one of my favorite blankets now. Anyway, so in today's video, we are talking about how you can't teach an old dog new tricks. And how that's one of the myths of dog training that I discuss in my new ebook, 7 Miracle Steps to Train Your Dog. There are a lot of myths about dog training. And hey, thank you for joining me. If you can hear me, post in the comments that you can hear me. I would really appreciate it. Make sure I didn't do anything wrong and screw this up. I would really appreciate it. So yeah, there are a bunch of myths about dog training. And I think for the most part, they come from the old way. First off, the old way of dog training, how we used to train dogs many, many years ago, decades ago, from misinformation that we had. So there are a lot of different myths, and we've been talking about some of those myths in some of the live videos I've been doing lately. So this is another one. And I used to hear this all the time that it's like a saying, like people say to each other, oh, you can't teach an old dog new tricks. Like it's part of our, it's just part of our lingo, like how we talk to each other. And I think a lot of, you know, older people may use it as in like, oh, I'm too old, I'm not gonna learn that. But it came from somewhere, and it came from people It came from people thinking that old dogs can't be taught new ideas or new things to do. And I think, I know, from experience, there is absolutely nothing further from the truth. Yeah, there are a couple of things to think about. First off, as a dog trainer, you know, you get dog. Sorry about that, guys. Live videos, these things happen. So first off, as a dog trainer, you get dogs all the way from puppy through adult years. And as we are more and more of a society to rescue and adopt older dogs, which I absolutely love, we have more and more dogs that are older that are in need of some training. And that's completely understandable because you have no idea what their past is like, where they came from, how they grew up, how they were raised. So when you adopt an older dog into your home, there's a lot of love and care that needs to go into that. And also, you know, people want to know how to better interact with older dogs and how to train them, because there is that old adage of you can't teach an old dog new tricks. It's just false. So yes, the truth is when you get a puppy, it's easy when you get a puppy to mold and shape them into the dog that you want them to be, a social, happy butterfly, right? Older dogs, it can happen for them too. We see it all the time. It takes a lot of love. But one thing that, people may not understand is that with a puppy, they have a ton of energy. It requires a lot of patience on the part of the owner or the trainer, both, to get past the energy of a puppy and get down to the training. And we talk about that a lot in my online video training and in my ebook, 7 Miracle Steps to Train Your Dog. So we talk about how you do have to get past the energy, right? So you need to help your dog in a healthy, creative way, get all of that energy out. Okay, that was bugging me. Get all of that energy out, and then we can get to the training part. And it doesn't have to be a difficult thing to do. There are a lot of games and enrichments. Just going on a hike, going for a long walk, maybe even a run, is going to be really great in getting all that puppy energy out. But when you have an older dog, they don't have as much energy. And, you know, if they're healthy and they're fed a species appropriate diet, they can have a good amount of energy, but you're not going to have that hurdle of energy that you do with a younger dog. So in many cases, I actually find that older dogs are easier to train because you don't have that hurdle of the energy to get over. And when you're, as a dog trainer, working with people in their homes, that is probably one of the biggest barriers that we have to cross with any dog, but especially with younger dogs, is getting them in the mindset and understanding that we have to get them through the energy, we have to expel that energy, and that's part of training. And a lot of people think, well, no, you just gotta get to it and tell them what to do and they need to do it. Well, we have to get over that energy. We have to let them express themselves, let them expel all of that energy in a healthy, productive way, and then we can get to the training. So with an older dog who maybe doesn't have quite as much energy as a young puppy, for me, I actually find it's a lot easier to train them. And, oh, my dog is over there hacking something up. Or I don't know what she's doing. What are you doing over there, sweet pea? You okay? You getting a toy? You good girl. You good girl. Okay. So, yeah. So you don't have that hurdle of all that energy. So I actually find it's a lot easier to train older dogs. And, you know, you do have to take into account with an older dog that maybe their body isn't in the great shape that it was when they were a puppy. Maybe they have some arthritis. So you have to make some adjustments and some changes. Maybe they aren't going to be able to sit on a hard floor, maybe because it hurts their bones. And we understand that. So we make some adjustments. We give them, you know, a bed, a blanket, a pillow, something to sit on so it's not so uncomfortable, or we move to a different surface. So it's all in working with your dog and not against your dog. So it is a huge myth of dog training that you can't teach an older dog new tricks. Complete myth. So I just want to get that out there. And it's just one of the myths that I talk about in my new book, my new ebook, 7 Miracle Steps to Train Your Dog. Go grab a copy. So many great nuggets of information in here. Put this up, bit.ly/7stepsdogtraining. If somebody could type that in the comments so it's easier for y'all to get to, I would really, really, really appreciate that. bit.ly/7stepsdogtraining. Go ahead and post that in the comments below so it's easier for everyone. If you're watching this live, if you're watching this later as a recording, go ahead and post it below. I would really appreciate it. Yeah, so just one of the many myths of dog training I cover in my new ebook, 7 Miracle Steps to Dog Training. And yes, you can teach an old dog new tricks. So, hey guys, these videos are for you. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. Dog training, dog behavior. We can talk about cats if you want to. Nutrition for your pets. I love talking about that. Put your questions below. I would love to answer them. Maybe even do a video to answer it for you. So with that, guys, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and share it if you found it useful. And follow me on social media, The Furry Family Coach. So with that, I'm gonna go ahead and end this video. Thank you so much for being with me today. I really appreciate it. I will see you in the next video.